Welcome to Honest Book Reviews. If you are new to the channel, please subscribe. Today we will be reviewing The Rising Strong: How the Ability to Reset Transforms the Way We Live, Love, Parent, and Lead book by Brené Brown. Brown has brought to the surface the thoughts and feelings this culture tries to ignore or deny. Book is about difficult emotional processes, what they offer us, what gets in the way of leaning into them, and about surprisingly serious consequences of avoiding them. Rising Strong takes the complex subject of mindfulness and explains it in a way all can understand. This book truly is a gift, but the key is to have the desire to put into practice what Brené writes about. She told a few personal stories that could have put her in a not-so-great light. If you're interested at all in the title, the back cover, or anything you believe this book may be about from browsing its content, just begin reading. If you're a creative, passionate soul who's risen to your calling only to fall again, and have repeated the pattern more than once, read this book. She shares how resilient people go about surviving bad events, and provides examples from her personal life to help get the points across. It gives you tools to help, especially in difficult situations, to clearly understand other people's perspective, being strong enough to talk about our struggles so that they don't become something much worse. This is a very important book for anyone struggling with being married, self-esteem, and how to get along after divorce. Easy, approachable writing style, lots of personal examples that make sense and can be implemented in your daily life immediately. Brené Brown leads you through the entire process of rising strong through any sort of difficulty you have in your life. Great self-help, and easy to listen to, with wonderful short stories that anyone can adapt to their own personal experience. This book is helpful to anyone who is looking for advice after facing adversity in their lives. Also, and in telling her stories, Brown focuses on the traditional dual biological parents model as her reference to families, even though less than 12% of the American population, and even less than that within the families themselves, fit into this box. Those are people who are in the arena 247, it seems, and would have some amazing stories to contribute to Rising Strong. Like most self-help books, a reader can sometimes come away feeling worse than better upon entering the journey. This is mainly due to the ability of writers to invite the reader to turn inward and analyze personal failings and shortcomings, yet that can trigger unresolved issues. Brown's disclaimer pages at the very end of the book about trauma and the helping professions probably should be moved to the front of the book. Readers with lifelong experiences in shame, blame, trauma, and dysfunctional family dynamics, to name just a few, most likely would benefit from this book under the guidance of a personal therapist or a legitimate support group. Whether it be a hard time personally or in business, this book can apply to it all. This book could lead to world peace by one person at a time, Rising Strong. If you are a spouse, a parent, or if you work on teams with other people, you must read this book. If you're on the fence, buy it. If you ended up here by mistake, buy it. Do yourself a favor, and all those around you, don't hesitate to read it. FYI, a stunning discourse on becoming an authentic person, invaluable in finding the courage, the wherewithal, the self-respect that are absolutely required to do so. Me gusta mucho el trabajo de Brené Brown, sus libros e investigaciones, y es libro no es la excepción. This was a very well-written, easy-to-follow book on how to become a better you. This book is a must for people who have been knocked down by life and are ready to get curious about their stories and feelings. Brené Brown has completed her trilogy in Rising Strong and outdone herself in the process. Optimism is dealing with the inevitable problems and stumbles in life by just keep trying. Each one stands on its own, but reading them in the order written is beneficial as they build upon each other. This one is focused on wholehearted living, taking chances, and getting back up when you fail. It's how to deal with all the falling down emotionally, and the desire, or lack of, to get back up again. Go slow, and find a safe space to handle those difficult sections where you have to dig deep in the traumas of your life. But if you love Brené, or you just want to make progress on your journey to healing and thriving, you'll love this book. Brené Brown shares all of her challenges, successes, and failures in the process of becoming whole. The first half of the book can be a bit of a cumbersome read, but keep going. There are many layers to understand in our own minds and in the minds of others. Great book that can help one increase their self-awareness of their relational strengths and weaknesses, allowing opportunity to work on those weaker areas so you get along better with more people and interact with more people from a place of genuine and internal strength. Brown for continuing to share her work with us. This book, along with the rest of her research, is so very important. Thank you for watching. Do not forget to subscribe and leave your comments below.